everyone, it's Jacqueline for Pixie Dust PhD. My partner Adam and I have just finished up the Paris portion of our France trip, and now we have made our way over to an offsite hotel at Disneyland Paris. I don't speak a lick of French, so apologies for the pronunciation. We are staying for one night at the Hôtel L'Elysée in Val d'Europe. This is one train stop away from Disneyland Paris. I booked a standard one double bed room for about $145 US. I will put information somewhere in the video here with exact amounts. It looks like we were given either a two double or a two queen room, so that's a neat upgrade. The hotel is a little bit bare on amenities. There's a bar and a restaurant, but for example, there's not a pool, but I'm actually pretty impressed with the room so far. So stay tuned if you want to see it. We were assigned room 232, that's here on the second floor of the hotel. And it looks like this is a two double or maybe a two queen room. So pretty standard hotel door. And you do have a light switch here. So this is on, this is off, this controls some lights in the main room. So it's not quite a master switch, it doesn't control everything, but it controls quite a lot of the lights. To the right, when you enter, you have your little closet set up. So here we've got some hangers. Notably, these are the kind where this part is attached to the bar. So you can't really move the hangers around, hang things up in the bathroom to steam, anything like that. You're gonna hang things, they're going to stay here. And again, we have only two hangers with the pant clips. This was the same as in our Paris hotel. So maybe this is standard for France. Moving along then, we have just some open shelves. We've got a safe here. We were provided with two robes and two sets of slippers. So that's a pretty nice touch for what I would consider probably a budget hotel. Here we have information for if you want to do laundry. They have a laundry service. We're only staying here for one night, so that's not applicable for us. But in case you are staying here for a longer amount of time, these are the rates. And then below we have this mini fridge with some water. So that's a pretty nice touch. Next to your open closet area, you have pretty much a full length mirror and then a bench. We're just storing some stuff on here. There's also room under the bench for you to store some luggage if you wish. To the left of your front door is this other door. This will be your bathroom. Again, we have the lights here, so lights on. And let's go in. It's actually a really large bathroom. I'm very impressed. So we have a combo tub shower, and you've got the adjustable shower head, and it goes quite tall. So that won't be an issue if you're very tall. It comes with shampoo and shower gel. And then here you've got your towels as well as a towel rack. The back of the door, you have a hook so you can hang your towels up here in addition to the towel rack. And then you have your toilet area, trash can. The hairdryer is built in here, which is interesting. And here's your sink area. The sink is rather large, but there's not actually very much counter space here for you. For one night, I'm not fussed at all, but if it was many more nights, even with only two people, it might be a little tough. Here you've got your hand wash, extra toilet paper. Below the sink are some other types of towels. You've got your hand towels and then just storage. So you could put your bathroom things here, but it would be pretty annoying to squat all this way down every time, in my opinion. And then you have a nice big mirror and like a built-in magnifying mirror, which is pretty fun. I don't think I've ever seen this before. You do have to lean in to use it, which is a little bit annoying in my opinion, but better than not having a magnifying mirror at all. And here is their disclaimer about, you know, guests not necessarily replacing their towels every day, trying to save on energy. So that's your bathroom. It is really large, I think. It's hard for me to describe how large it is, but for a hotel bathroom, it's huge. I mean, so here's the door, for example. And you can swing it all the way inside. I mean, it's weighted, so it doesn't want to stay open. But that's how big this bathroom is. All right, so once again, if I am at the door, you've got your closet area, safe, etc. on the right, your bathroom to the left, and now let's move into the main room. Again, we booked a one double bed, so this is either two doubles or maybe two queens, I'm not too sure. If they are two queens, they're a little smaller than American queens. If they are two doubles, I think they're maybe a little bigger than American doubles. But here's the beds. Got this fun wallpaper behind them. And your headboard is slightly padded, nothing major, but it's nice. You have a general lamp and then also a reading lamp. And then in terms of light switches, this interestingly turns on and off that light, as well as your hall light, which maybe you can tell a little bit when I do that. So that's kind of like a, oh, I'm already in bed and forgot to do the light situation. And then these, I haven't been able to figure out for the life of me what these do. So honestly, I don't know. Then you've got two USB plugs here. There are no standard plugs, European or otherwise, on your bedside tables. So here's your bed. We've got these linens, three pillows. Pretty squishy. In terms of bedding, there's this padding. It's pretty thin though. And then just like a standard mattress, nothing special. And then they put a top sheet on as a fitted sheet. So it's not quite a fitted sheet and you're not able to use it as a top sheet. So you've got basically a duvet comforter situation. That will be your bedding. Moving backwards a little bit, before we get into the beds, if you turn right, there is an adjoining door here. We've just stacked our luggage here since we do not need the adjoining room function. But if you want an adjoining room, that is an option. And here we have our air conditioning. I've turned it off just for the sake of the audio on the video, but we had it on earlier and it seems to work pretty well. When you're not in the room, it's reset to 21 degrees Celsius, so I'm guessing there's some sort of sensor that will see if you are moving around or not. Across from this first bed, we have this little cabinet. Here you have a hot pot, some cups, some coffee stirrers. I think this is maybe hot chocolate. I'm honestly not sure. I'm guessing this is sugar, maybe creamer. I think this is tea. These are all brands I'm entirely unfamiliar with. And also I don't drink coffee or tea, so generally unfamiliar to begin with. But you know, you've got your little setup here basically. And then there's a couple shelves here. My partner's things are in here. Here we have our emergency pillows, which I think is a very funny translation. I'm guessing these are just extra pillows. And I think this bag is probably trash from the last guest, so housekeeping doesn't catch everything, but that's not a big deal in my opinion. Then we've got our TV remote, our TV. The middle side table between the two beds, again, you have the lamp and the reading light. They're controlled by these switches. Same light switches here, same sort of day-night dimmer that I don't know what it controls, USBs, and here we have the phone. To the best of my knowledge, there's nothing really of importance under the side tables. It looks like you've got maybe one standard European plug down here that you could use. But most of the plugs in the rooms are just going to be USBs. And here's the second bed. Same thing on this side. You've got your lamp, your reading light, two USBs, side table. Really nothing of importance under the side table, but you can store some things down there if you want. And turning around, under the TV, we have this desk working area. Here is your coffee maker. It's a Krups. It's a sort of fake Nespresso. It came with four of these pods. I think these are normal coffee and these are decaffeinated coffee, but again, I don't drink coffee, so correct me if I'm wrong. On the desk, they provided these two door hangers. So this first one is if you are staying for two nights or more, you can hang this on your door basically to decline housekeeping, and you get a 5-euro chip for the bar, so sort of like a credit, which is nice. And then here's just your standard do not disturb sign. This is the hotel key. I thought it was nice. And then the hotel key sleeve has services and opening hours for breakfast and the restaurant, as well as the bar. And notably, the bar's open from, it seems like, 10 a.m. to 12 a.m. midnight, which is pretty generous hours for a bar. This desk also had this fun wooden cube, so you've got the hotel lease. Again, you have some hours here for breakfast. If you need amenities, you can call 9. No smoking in the rooms. You can get late checkout on demand. And then here is a QR code that I believe will take you to the hotel website. We basically just commandeered this desk to do our charging for the night. And here you have your tissues, a nice floor lamp, and a comfy chair. These are the blackout curtains. They do overlap quite a lot, so I don't think we're gonna have any issues with light bleeding through in the morning, but I will report back tomorrow and let you know. And then you have this sheer curtain, which is nice. And at least from our room, we do have doors that open and you can see out fully. There's nothing really special, but it's nice to be able to totally open your doors if you want. We took the RER A train from Paris out to Val d'Europe, and then we just rolled our suitcases. It's only about a half a block to Hotel Elise, so it's very convenient. Check-in was fast and simple. I will let you know tomorrow how we feel about the beds and the shower in terms of water temperature and pressure. I can tell you right now, I've laid down on the beds and they seem on the firmer side of things, not a lot of plushness there. So over to you, future Jacqueline. All right, we slept the night at Hotel Le Elise, and yeah, the beds are on the firmer side. I wouldn't quite say they're uncomfortable, but they're definitely not soft or plush, so be prepared for that. Additionally, we found out this plug under the center console here, the center side table, is just for show. It doesn't actually plug into anything, but there is an additional plug by the front door. So here's that outlet. Overall, there are not a lot of actual outlets you can use. It's mostly USB, so pros and cons to that. And a fun thing about the mirror, I didn't notice, you can turn lights on and off here. And that will light up the magnification mirror and the light bar here. And you can make it brighter or less bright by holding these buttons. Overall, we had a fairly comfortable stay. Again, it was only one night, so I can't speak to everything, but I think for the rate you are paying, it's well worth it. The convenience to the train station is huge. It's absolutely great for sort of your arrival night to Disneyland Paris to make the most of your on-site package if you have one. If you have any questions, leave those in the comments down below. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel. You can ring the bell icon to receive notifications whenever I upload new videos. We're off to Disneyland Paris now, so we'll see you real soon at Pixie Dust PhD.